Hey guys, Charles back after another, you know, hiatus. I figured I'd just upload a couple of videos and not feel like it. Into the swing of things, but yes, we are back on global. I mean, we are back on Dokkan, not global. Yes, we are on JP. I know that my screen is a little skewed a little as far as the video. Not sure why that is currently. I think it's honestly just my phone. So if it bothers you, I'm sorry, but I can't really fix it at the moment. So in today's video, I kind of wanted to go over getting the current team I have now, which is the EZA Gohan and getting the 100% free Ginyu Force, which actually when you get all these guys, when you get all these guys 100%, it gives you the ally Ginyu. I'm pretty sure you guys know that. That is going to be stuck on that here, so you can run the Ginyu Force team. So honestly, the real reason why I actually did this over on JP, I don't main JP, I still haven't thought about maining JP at all. I'm only doing this because, honestly, the real reason I think you should be getting the EZA Gohan from this event right here. I don't have the units to go past 56, so you want to give me 4 stars, you just need to pull mine on SCI to get the EZA Gohan. I digress. So the real reason why I did the grind from Ginyu Force, which they are available on their respective type day, so Beretta will be available on AGL, and going by color, I guess you can figure out who's going to be available on which day. And they're permanently available. You don't have to worry about the event leaving, they're just going to always be there. I think that's a great thing for the free-to-play players. They can have like an actual decent team with a free ally that goes with it. The only complaint I have about said LR is they only give you one copy, so you can't. So I don't have any units on JP anyway, so I got mine to SD10 and put orbs in because they can give you out more crazy. So the LR gave you good to that simple color. I just like to call it the tech ally Ginyu Force. So they only give you one copy of the card. And so you can't open up any paths or get any dupes to, I guess, 100% the card. Which to me doesn't make a whole lot of sense considering that they gave you a full team of 100% units. So why wouldn't they give you a free 100% ally? I guess because that's reserved for the ally Vegeta Blue, which you can only get on TOR, on JP. Anyway, unfortunately, because I'm missing a Fierce Battle Int type unit on JP, I cannot get him currently. I have started to grind a little bit for him. I wonder how many stones I have. We're going to figure this out, and then we're going to get into the actual reason for the video. Right now, there's only, I'm going to see. So right now, there are 4 copies, so that means you can open up 3 new packs for him until JP decides to release the rest of the stuff. I don't know, but, so, going back to what I was talking about, the real reason to get these guys up and all the other stuff for, you know, for the free-to-play players and all that, and just, you know, pay people who are in EZKP, you know, is to do this. It is exactly to do this whole entire thing, since, even on global, since the LR, Frieza, and Goku Sages can now use drop cards, the EZA Gohan is a drop card, I believe, has the EZA event to get him to EZA ends in Japan on the 6th, so you still have like a day or so to farm him up. He becomes a Namasaga category lead, so HP attack and defense up 77% plus 3 key. And this cool thing Ginyu Force is... I'm just going to address all the Ginyu Force units as the Ginyu Force, because that's who they are. I'm not going to name them because that's stupid. So the real reason to do it is to... If you're starting out on JP, it's a great team to use... it's a phenomenal team. It runs really well. They link very well, even though how many people, because they share Shattering the Limit. I know a lot of people still crap on Shattering the Limit, but in the day that Dokkan has been out and with all these units, including some of the LRs, don't have Fierce Battle, they have Shattering the Limit. Shattering the Limit is actually a really good link for, in my opinion, for the LRs. That is a really good link, especially if you want certain units to have, like the AT&T Super or whatever. You know, it's just really good. So we're just gonna hop into the LR in a little bit, and do get into the real reason for the video. We're not gonna have to use any items on here. Honestly, most turns we're just gonna one shot them. This is the physical stage where you can get the dupes for the units. Dupes to open up all the paths, get them to SA10, get them farming another one to SA10, and then move them to each other. If you do that, I'm going to do that because I would actually like the LR Goku for my mono super tech team, because I actually have the tech product on this version of the game. So we're just going to show you how to use pretty much. And this goes for LR Frieza too. I'm just gonna show you how pretty much how easy this is. And this is the reason why you should actually get these cards. So Budo actually you can stun and he lowers his attack for two turns. Raccoon is just a tank. And Gohan gets more attack and defense based on the orb he gathers. So it really doesn't matter how many. So they link really well because they're all share Shattering the Limit. So they're always gonna need like two or whatever. The Ginyu Force links really well to the point where you get two one shot. Like this event actually kind of hard when it like first came out. So Ginyu is also just a tank. Birda, if you put him in the first slot, he has a chance to dodge. Honestly, I don't care because he doesn't have any super moves. So, you know, 9 damage. This is honestly the best thing you can do. It makes this run so much easier. You don't have to wait like a couple of turns. Jace here, he provides key to extreme type as well as I believe the attack and defense boost. And if we see these little circles right here, he can show you what the super attack would be. Normally for the super attacks it would be red, so you would not say one turn, no items needed, no need to gather up the ability to block time. Oh wow. I wasn't playing JP at the time that the Ally Goku campaign came out, so it is what it is. I just think that this stuff still costs 50 stamina. They should honestly just permanently half that. But yeah, like 3 minutes. My actual fair time is like 2 minutes, but no, explaining the video and all that other stuff. So So yeah, I just wanted to show you guys that, honestly, that's, if you're starting JP, I highly recommend getting these units. It gives you a nice team that can, you know, beat probably all the Dokkan upgrades that are available. They're actually really good units. Some of them are actually really good into the battle rate as well. So if you're starting out on JP, get the Ginyu Force cards if you can. Get the GTA Gohan before he leaves. As far as the GTA events, none of which of them have come back yet. No Goku, no Broly. You know, Broly just left, but GTA Gohan, nobody knows when these GTA events are going to come back or if they will come back. If you play Global and you don't play JP, just be prepared to do this. Honestly, with the Frieza, the Fourth Stage Frieza event, you should be farming your LF users right now. That campaign, I'm pretty sure, is going to hit whenever they decide to, now that they released it, because now Global and JP can both farm him correctly, so it would make it, you could probably see that again coming pretty soon. But that's going to be the video, guys. This is Chao signing off. I'm going to try to be, I know I keep making promises, but I'm going to try to be at least upload something like once a week. That's probably 4K. I'm dog sitting these next couple days, so I'll try to get some stuff pre-recorded. But anyway, that's going to be the video, guys.